Hey folks, welcome to video 2 in the series on Run by Snow Patrol. This video is going to feature all of the guitar parts that are in the tablature, which is available on my blog. In the previous video, we just did guitar 1. This video is going to include all the extra guitar parts, the solo at the end, the arpeggios and stuff in the choruses, and that little tremolo bit. So, let's get to it. So there's the second of the Run videos in which we combine all of the various guitar parts together. Now, I'd like to talk to you about what's going on at my feet. I've got a floorboard down here with a bunch of effects on it. And I switch some of those on and off at various times in the different parts. So let's talk about what's going on down here. This floorboard here is basically my electric guitar rig. This foot switch here controls channels on the amp. Channel B here is a light crunch. And it's just left on that for all of the various guitar parts. Up here, we've got a TC Electronic Plethora X5. This is a great pedal, really, really versatile. I have it set quite simply with a little compressor here that's on all the time throughout this song. The other effects that I'm going to use are the reverb, which is on pretty much all the time. Nice little bit of spacey echo there. And also, I'm going to use the tremolo for a couple of those parts in guitar 2. The other thing I have is this MXR overdrive, distortion pedal, distortion plus. So that gets switched on for the choruses. Nope, there we go. And occasionally then I'll use this volume pedal. Just all I'm using it for in this song is really just to kill the volume for parts where I don't have any sound. So for example, in guitar 2, I'll play the little tremolo part. And then just pull the volume back while there's a gap, so that I don't get any accidental sounds from the guitar. The other thing that I do for the solo parts at the end, I change the setting on the distortion pedal and I turn it way up so that the distortion is way, way, way heavier, and we get this sort of much, much crunchier kind of sound there. This distortion pedal is a kind of a movable feast. Sometimes I'll switch it out for, I've also got this Brian May, I'll show it over here. I've got this Brian May treble booster, which I use most of the time, but I find that's way too harsh for the Stratocaster, so I tend not to use it with the Strat. So the MXR is quite nice. I've got a couple other overdrive pedals that I'll switch in and out there, and often I'll use just the channels on the amp are set with various levels of distortion. So my cup runneth over with distortions. But that's basically it. It's not crazy complicated. The main thing that you have to try and get used to with guitar effects is kicking them on and off at the right time. It's very, very easy to have a setup where you've got all of these lovely sounds, which I think I do, but if you're not kicking the pedals on and off at the right time, you can get some nasty kind of overlaps and things like that. So for example, you're playing your, there's your first part, and I want to switch to the overdrive, to the distortion on the chorus, and but I missed it. So I didn't get the proper sort of distortion effect kicking in at the right time there. So you just have to be careful to, you know, kick them on and off at the right time. It takes a little bit of getting used to. Like anything, it's a kind of a mechanical skill. It takes a little bit of practice. And if you're starting out with electric effects, it can be, you know, something that you haven't necessarily considered before. You know, exactly when it is that you should kick that switch on or off is vitally important. You know, nowadays when we're recording at home, it's very easy to play the clean part, stop, take a break, switch your all effects to your new setting, then record a new part with the overdriven part on it, which is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. That's how they do it in the studio most of the time. Live though, if I'm the only guitarist on stage, I can't stop and go, excuse me a second, I'll just, and then we'll take the chorus over again. So it's worth practicing playing with your effects, clean part, distortion part, tremolo on, tremolo off, whatever it might happen to be, volume at a certain level, amp, foot switches, you know, they're a part of the sound as well, and it's you know, it's part of playing the electric guitar that's important to consider. So I hope you've enjoyed playing Run by Snow Patrol with me. I hope you've enjoyed looking at my foot switches and floorboard, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Good luck.